What's going on YouTube? Dr. Ironbat Prime 2.0 back again with another video. And as you clicked on this video, this is just a way of custom. This is just my way of customizing a Boba Fett blaster from, well, Star Wars, of course. I saw this on Amazon, spent like some of my birthday money on it, and I figured this would be a perfect time to, well, customize this thing. I mean, I saw this and just figured, well, it'd be perfect to do. Plus, a couple of YouTubers have had this kind of thing, and well, they have different methods. And here's my method on customizing this thing. I mean, it's a Boba Fett blaster from Star Wars. I figured I'd try and do it while we're still under quarantine, because I mean, at the point in time you're videoing this, I mean, the virus is still spreading. Lots of, well, everyone's just trapped at home. And if you're very bored or you just want to work on something around the house, this would be a perfect time to just have a fun prop to work on and make. But also, I just figured this would be a fun time to just work on a video on how I made this. Now, I'm also gonna be like, it's basically just a matter of like some sanding, drilling in some holes, painting, and well, spray painting, and then a tad bit of Mall Master paint and all that. And yeah, I can get this done within a day. Like, first thing I'm gonna do is like sand off the, well, just the warning stuff right here, along with, well, drilling in the holes for the blaster and the scope. Cause I mean, there's some detail on this thing that I really like, and just have to, you know, just drill the holes in. And then I'll just continue with working on this thing. So let me sand these off first. So one of my next things I'm gonna do right now is, well, I got some silver, well, Mall Master paint. Just gonna put a little bit on the side just so that way, well, I'm able to, well, I don't want to throw in a big glop right there on the blaster when it's fully blackened right now. But one of the things I'm gonna do is just wipe away different areas where, well, where it looks like there's going to be some exposed metals, because I mean, this thing's been used, it has been fired several times. I mean, come on, I mean, it's the world of Star Wars. Everything's often used, fired, blasted. I mean, come on. And that's just a quick example of what I'm doing. It's basically just dabbing it away, just very lightly brushing it, just like that. And I'm gonna be doing this throughout the rest of the gun in many different areas, so but doing this could take like, well, it could take, I don't know, maybe 15 or 20 minutes. But now you get the picture of what I'm doing with all this. I'm not gonna go overboard and do like every inch of it, but I'm just gonna do like some areas here and there, like right here, a little there, and on the scope. Yeah, but yeah, that's the plan of what I'm gonna do. So I took care of, well, putting in all the silver, well, all the silver bowel damage, you know, the metal look, especially on like the end of the blaster. Yeah, I put it all over the place and everything, and yeah, that's basically it on like adding in all the silver metals. Now, one next thing I'm gonna do is add in like a rust look, because I mean, the weapon looks very rusty-like, and it just looks very bowel damaged, very old. Like, Boba Fett's used this thing a million times. So I'm going in with, like, a chestnut brown. I'm just gonna be, like, just putting some right here on the side, and then just dab it away all over the place with a sponge brush that I'm gonna try and use. And, yeah, I'm gonna see how it all turns out, and then... But if it's too much, I could always wipe it away with a paper towel. So, yeah, I'm just gonna see how that goes and plays out. And now at the point in time of videoing this, it's been a few minutes since I've did the sponge brush on the, well, all the rust on it, and, well, now it's time for the clear gloss. And once you've applied clear gloss all over, like, all over the whole blaster, it's finally completed, and now, here's the end result. So that is it. This is the completed Boba Fett blaster that was used in Star Wars. And I gotta say, I really liked how I made this thing. I really wanted to nail it out of the park on what it looked like and everything, and I'm just overall surprised with how good it is now, and this is just another prop to go in my room. It's definitely now going somewhere in here. But overall, really love how this thing turned out, and it's just perfect, it's good, and again, I just really like it. I mean, so at the point in time me videoing this, I know we're all under quarantine, but if you really want to work on something, like, and not just sit around and do nothing, and you want a new project to work on, this would be a perfect one to work on. It's just a quick run to, like, well, just order this on Amazon for like $20, and you can pick up all the supplies you need at like your local, like, well, at your local Hobby Lobby or Lowe's. I mean, sure, stores might be hard to come by right now because, I mean, most places are temporarily closed, but hey, I mean, you can always order them online. But again, this is how I made it, and I'm pretty sure y'all have your ways of making it. And, well, I mean, and making this took me literally, like, it literally took me, like, a day to make, so, yeah. And it was so worth it. It was so worth the $20, so worth making. I mean, and I just, again, really like the end result of how this blaster came. So, yeah, I mean, you could have this done within a day, because, I mean, well, I mean... I started this thing at noon, and right now at the point in time me videoing this, it is almost like 8 o'clock. So yeah, I mean, this was so worth it. So if you're interested in wanting to make this would be a fun project to do. So if you're in any way of like wanting to cosplay as Boba Fett or a Mandalorian, or even just have like. Or just want to work on a for fun project, or need a blaster like this for your next cosplay or Comic-Con, if it's not postponed or anything, or you just want to work on this kind of thing for fun, this would be a perfect one to work on. So worth the $20, and, well, all the things that you'll need. So anyways, thank you all for watching. I really hope you like how I made this prop, and hope y'all took some notes and everything, and Well, let's just go ahead and wrap up on this video, because there's not much else to talk about, but I really hope you like how this thing turned out. So, just to wrap it up, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed already. Hit the bell to notify whenever I upload a video. Hit some comments, I'm always reading comments down there. And don't forget to, hit the thumbs up so I know you like this video or even love it. And also, don't forget to follow me on social media. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, CosplayMino, Facebook, TikTok. That's all my social media names. You can follow me on social media if you just type that in on social media. And I just might follow you back. So, till next time, guys. And we're still under quarantine, so stay safe. Hope you all are doing well. And don't forget to wash your hands. But if you're planning to go outside, like if you have to go to work or want to just go for a run, or you have to make a quick stop at a store or even grab a bite to eat somewhere, just stay extra careful. But till next time, guys. I'll see you all in my next video. And, this is the way, of course. And I have spoken.